chapter number 11, Water for Life. Okay, all of you open your EVS textbook and come to page number 89. Okay, now here, reading ahead, read the given lines and answer these questions. Water, water everywhere, and all the boats did shrink. Water, water everywhere, no any drop to drink. These lines have been taken from a famous poem. Find out the name of the poem and the poet. What water bodies do you think the poet is referring to? Okay, here it is the poem. Whatever I have read right now. Water, water everywhere, and all the boats did shrink. So that is the poem taken from the famous poem. So it is the portion of that poem taken from that big poem. And you have to find out which poem it is. The name of the poem from which we have taken the part. You have to find the name of that poem along with the poet name. Okay. And they, one more question they are asking here. Which water body do you think the poet is referring? Here water bodies means rivers, pond, lakes, streams are all water bodies. So to which water body the poet is referring to? So whether he is referring to river or pond or lake, so that you have to find out here. So search in the Google or ask your elders, parents, you also search. So I will also search and in the next class I will tell you. Okay, now sources of water. Here sources of water. All living beings need water to survive. Okay, we know that approximately 3/4 of our planet is covered with water. So about water we have learned in your previous class also, means in the third standard also there is a lesson of water. So here also you are going to learn about the water chapter, but that is somewhat extra portion is given as compared to third standard. Here in the fourth standard they will give you some more extra about the water. Okay, that you have to learn here. Now all living beings need water to survive. As you know, all the living beings, whether it may be plant, animal, wild animal, domestic animals, even human beings also need the water to survive. Here survive means for living. If we want to live, so jeevan tirlak namge en beku, neer beku. Okay, we know that approximately 3/4 of our planet is covered with water. So all of you know, approximately 3/4 of our planet is covered with water. Here 3/4 means, see, so our earth is having the round shape. Here 3/4 means I will divide the whole earth into 4 parts. And among these 4 parts, 3/4 means these are the 4 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4. I have divided the earth into 4 equal parts. So among these 4 equal parts, these 3 parts means these three parts are covered by water and only one part is the land. Okay. Bhagavala, bhagavala, mire tumboga, deli, bhoomi mele. Only one portion in the other land. Adha. So, alenu, navu asamadthi. Okay. Now, however, most of this water is in the form of salt water in the seas and oceans of the world. However, as I have told you, 3/4 of the earth is covered by water. So, in that 3/4 water, most of the water is salty. Okay. So, as you know, our world is covered. Ivaga bhala samudra galu sagaragalu bhala avanume. So, samudra matu sagaragalu da yav riti neerutho salty water irutho uppu neerutho. Okay. So, here. However, most of this water is in the form of salt water in the seas and oceans of the world. Okay. So, among this 3/4 of the water, most of the water is salty. Okay. So that salty water is present in oceans and seas of the world. Okay, now wait. Okay, now water is available on the surface of the earth as fresh water and salt water. Let us read more about them. Okay, water is available on the earth in the two forms. Okay, the two forms are, the first one is fresh water and the second one is salt water. Water is present on the earth in the two forms. Okay, the names of two forms is, the first one is fresh water and them. Means now let us read in detail about these. What is fresh water and what is salt water? Okay. First of all, we will learn about the first one, that is about fresh water. Okay. So see here, what do you mean by fresh water and where it is available? So about all these things we will learn. Fresh water. Fresh water is found in rivers, lakes, ponds, ice caps, and as ground water. Okay. This fresh water is found in rivers, lakes, ponds, ice caps, and ground water. Here you know rivers, lakes, and ponds. But what do you mean by ice caps? So at the bottom they have given word stop. Okay, here you can see word stop is there. So here they have given the meaning of ice cap. Ice cap means a layer of ice that permanently covers parts of a earth. Okay, ice cap means it is a layer of the ice. Okay. Ice cap is a layer of the ice which covers a part of a earth. Okay. So the fresh water is available in rivers, ponds, lakes, ice caps, and the last one is ground water. So ground water we will get in the wells and borewells. Okay. Now we all know that rain is the most important source of water. So we all know that rain is the most important source of water. If rain comes, then only there will be water in the rivers, oceans, seas, lakes, and ponds. If there is no rain, then we will not get the water. All the rivers, ponds, and they will get dry. Okay. Nadigalu enu halla kolala olugutho yavaga mali berabeku. So that's why rain is the important, or you can say the main source of water. The rain water refills both the surface water and ground water. Okay. The rain refills what? The rain refills both surface water and ground water. So the ground water means ivaga bhavida neeru thoru avuk en antivu ground water. Surface water means this rivers, ponds, lakes na en water irta avuk anu surface water antu. Okay. Now let's brainstorm. The fresh water in the ice caps is not available for human use. Why? We can discuss. Okay. So you know, ice cap is in the form of fresh water only, but that is not available for human beings use. Why? You have to think about it. Okay. Now, the fresh water that is found on the surface of the earth is called surface water. Okay. So here one more term I am going to define. That is, what is fresh water? Sorry, not the fresh water. What is surface water? Okay, surface water means here the fresh water that is found on the earth. Surface water is also a kind of fresh water. The fresh water. The fresh water that is found. That is found on the surface, the surface of the earth is called what? Is called surface water. Okay, so the fresh water that is found on the surface of the earth is nothing but the surface water. Okay, this includes water in rivers, lakes, and ponds. Okay, so the example for the surface water or the sources for the surface water are, so rivers, lakes, and ponds. Here you can see the surface waters. Okay, now the fresh water that trickles through the soil and collects between the cracks or spaces in the soil is called the groundwater. So now, what do you mean by groundwater? Groundwater. Okay, I will write here. Groundwater. So groundwater means the fresh water that trickles through the soil and collects between the cracks or spaces in the soil is called groundwater. Here surface water is also a kind of fresh water. and here ground water is also a kind of fresh water. But what is the difference between both of them? Means their availability, the place of their availability is different. Okay, they are available in different places. So surface water is available on the surface of the earth, whereas this ground water, so when the rain comes, no, so then the rain drops trickles through the under honey. ಏನ್ ನೀರಿನ ಹನಿಗಳು ಇರ್ತಾವ ಏನ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಮಣ್ಣು ಇರ್ತಾವ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಮಣ್ಣಿನ ಮೂಲಕ ಹನಿ ಹನಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಏನ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಗ ಏನು ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ನೆಲದ ಕ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಬಿರುಕುಗಳು ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಬಿರುಕು ಅಥವಾ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಗ ಎಲ್ಲ ದೊಡ್ಡ ದೊಡ್ಡ ರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಇರ್ತಾವ, ಅದ್ರ ಸಂದುಗಳನ್ನ ಹರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿ ಅಂಡರ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಕೆಳಗ ಜಮಾ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾವ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್. ಸೊ ನಾವ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ವಾಟರ್. ದ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ವಾಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ವಾಟರ್ that trickles through the soil and collects between the cracks or spaces in the soil. In the soil is called what? Is called groundwater. Okay. So what is groundwater? The fresh water that trickles through the soil and collects between the cracks or spaces in the soil is called ground water. Okay. Define what is surface water and what is ground water. So now let us learn in detail about surface water. Okay. Surface water. Here, rivers. So right now only I have told you the surface water is available in rivers, ponds, and lakes. Okay. So first of all, let us learn about rivers. Okay. In the surface water. Rivers are flowing streams of water that differ in size. Okay, what are rivers? Rivers are the flowing streams of water. Ek ghar pe aise ho, so that like that only. Streams means jharke. Okay, rivers are flowing streams of water that differ in size. Okay, now they are an important source of water. These rivers are an important source of water. The water in the rivers comes from rain or from melting snow in the mountains or hills. Okay, the water in the rivers comes from where? The water in the rivers comes from rain or from the melting snow in the mountains or hills. So as you know, some of the mountains are having snow covered on them. So like Himalayas. Okay, so they are the mountains, hills on which the snow is covered. In the summer season, what happens when the sun heat sun shine? ಇವಾಗ ಬಿಸಿಲು ಇರ್ತದ ನೋಡಿ, ಬಿಸಿಲು ಬಿತ್ತು ಈ ಸ್ನೋ ಮೇಲ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಐಸ್ ಇರ್ತದ. ಈಗ ಏನಿರ್ತದ, ಮೌಂಟೇನ್ಸ್ ಮೇಲೆಲ್ಲ ಐಸ್ ಇರ್ತದ. ಈಗ ಮಳೆ ಏನ್ಸ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಈಗ ಸಮ್ಮರ್ ಏನಿರ್ತದ, ಬಿಸಿಲು ಬಿದ್ದು ಅದೇನಿರ್ತದ, ಸ್ನೋ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕರಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಕರಗಿದ ಏನು ಸ್ನೋ ಆಗ ನೀರಿನ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ. ಇವಾಗ ಯಾವಾಗ ಐಸ್ ಕರಗ್ತದ ನೀರು ಇರ್ತದಲ್ಲ, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿರ್ತದ, ಐಸ್ ಕರಗಿ ನೀರು ಐತ, ಅದು ನೀರು ಅಮ್ಮ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದ, ಬಂದು ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ನಾಗ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್. Now, some rivers originate from large lakes. The place from where rivers originates is called its source. Okay. Some rivers originate from the large lakes. The place from where the river originates is called source. So what is source? Here source means the place from where rivers originate is called source. Originate means उत्तर तो ये लिंग दल स्टार्ट है तो दा ओके ओरिजिन मींस द सोर्स ये ओरिजिन को ये कोटर नो बिगिन ये लिंग दल तो बिगिन है तो ये लिंग दल ये आउट दूर बिगिन ही करतो ओके अगर ये लिंग स्टार्ट है तो दा आदि क्या ने दिया आप लेसी की सोर्स है तो ओके मोस्ट रिवर्स स्टार्ट एस स्मॉल स्ट्रीम स्ट्रीम जॉइन टुगेदर टू फॉर्म द रिवर्स मोस्ट रिवर्स स्टार्ट एस स्मॉल स्ट्रीम ओके सो इन द बिगिनिंग मोस्ट ऑफ द रिवर्स स्टार्ट एज द स्ट्रीम झरपी करते ने स्टार्ट है ओके स्टार्टिंग द मेन मेन बिगिनिंग प्लेस झरपी टाइप दीज स्ट्रीम्स जॉइन टुगेदर टू फॉर्म रिवर्स ओके सो मेनी स्ट्रीम्स जॉइन टुगेदर टू फॉर्म ए रिवर ओके स्मॉलर स्ट्रीम्स ऑल्सो जॉइन द मेन रिवर एंड मेक इट लार्ज ओके स्मॉल स्मॉल स्ट्रीम्स ऑल्सो जॉइन द रिवर टू मेक इट लार्ज ओके ಸಣ್ಣ ಸಣ್ಣ ಜರ್ಪಿ ಒಂದು ಈ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಬಂತು ಈ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಬಂತು ಈ ಕಡೆಯಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಬಂತು ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಒಂದು ಬಂತು ಒಂದು ಏಳೆಂಟು ಜರ್ಪಿಗಳಾಗಿ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ರಿವರ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಡ್ತದೆ ಓಕೆ ನಾವು ದ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿವರ್ ನೋ ಮೋ ಓಕೆ ಐ ಆಮ್ ರೀಡಿಂಗ್ ದ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ನೋ ಮೋ ದ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ರಿವರ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿವರ್ ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ದ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ರಿವರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರಿವರ್ ಈಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ದ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ರಿವರ್ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸೈಡ್ಸ್ ನೋ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಸೈಡ್ So these two sides, we are having two sides. So the sides, these are known as banks of river. You have already heard nadi dande, beach anti road, samudra gali beach irtho. But in case of river, we are having banks. The sides of the rivers are called as banks. Sometimes during heavy rains, rivers overflow their banks and spread to the surrounding areas, resulting in floods. Okay, sometimes during ವಾಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂರಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿ ರೇನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವಾಗ ಭಾಳ ಮಳೆ ಬಿತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತದ ನದಿ ತುಂಬ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದ ಅದ್ರ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಓಕೆ ಅದ್ರದ್ದೇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಇರ್ತದ ಕಿನಾರ ಏನಿರ್ತದ ಅದ್ರ ಕಿನಾರ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತದ ನೀರು ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತ ಏನ್ ಸರೌಂಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಏರಿಯಾ ಇರ್ತದ ಅಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲ ನೀರು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದ ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತ ಮನೆಗಳಿದ್ದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮನೆಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಚ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಯ್ತಾವ ಭಾಳ ಸಲ ನೀವು ನ್ಯೂಸ್ನ ಕೇಳಿರ್ಬೋದು ಕೋಸಿ ನದಿ ಒಂದ್ಸಲ ಆಗಿದ್ದು ಬಿಹಾರ್ನ ಭಾಳ ತುಂಬ ಹರಿದು ರೈನಿ ಸೀಸನ್ ಅದೇ ಇರ್ತದೆ ನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಲಡ್ ಬಂತು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಲಡ್ ಬಂತು ಎಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಕೊಚ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋದ್ರು ಅಲ್ಲಷ್ಟು ಮನೆಗಳು ನಾಶ ಆದವು So that is when the river overflows, then it comes above its banks and the water will refills in the surrounding areas, resulting in flood. So when the river overflows, overflows means yavaga neeru idela banks irtho dandelu irtho adu kala rasthe nilla tara common aga kaanthu thirukodu. When the water overflows, en idu bank ki cross maadu bantu neeru andru avaga enaitva resulting in flood, pravaha antiru flood aagi. ಫ್ಲಡ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಾಯ್ತದ ಸುತ್ತಮುತ್ತ ಏರಿಯಾದಾಗಿನ ಮನೆಗಳು ಎಲ್ಲ ಡೆಸ್ಟ್ರೋ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾವ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಜನ ಕೊಚ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರ ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ನೀರಿನಾಗ ಮುಳುಗ್ತಾವ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದ ಫ್ಲಡ್ ಓಕೆ ನಾವು ಸಮ್ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ವೈಲ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಸೊ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಫ್ಲೋ ಫಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಆಸ್ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ರಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಪೆಬಲ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ವೆನ್ ದ ರಿವರ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಲೋ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾರಿ soil rocks and pebbles along with them okay ivan neer harita irta neer harita idag en aitada avu rocks iga en sand sandu kallu pebbles adu color color kall irtav so adu matte en soil iga reeti irtu reeti avela tagol kochkon aitav iga neevu neer ellindara nodbodu neevu neer bhaala fast aga rilatadu mandala adu jodiya hoytadu so adhe reeti soil rocks and pebbles when the rivers flow no so at that time they will carry soil rocks and pebbles along with them ಓಕೆ ನೌ rivers usually end in the sea okay rivers originate means rivers ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಯ್ತದ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತೀವಿ So alone the end is where it ends. End is there. So where the river ends, so that is nothing but sea. Okay. Again, the river harcourt bandi harcourt bandi. When the sea or the ocean is moving, kalt bharta ho, mix a ho gaya. So that is the ending place of that river. Okay. The place where the river meets the sea is called the mouth of the river. Okay. The place where the river meets the sea is called the mouth of river. Okay. So what is mouth of the river? The place where the river meets the sea is called mouth of the river. Mouth of the river. Okay. Now, when the river reaches the sea, it loses its speed and splits into branches. So when the river meets the sea, at that time it loses its speed and it gets split into many branches. नदी हरकत समुद्र सी बंद रीच आई स्पीड स्पीड मत ब्रांचेस स्प्लीट आके ब्रांचेस स्वल स्प्रेड ओके सो दीज आर द ब्रांचेस विच आर गेटेड विच आर स्प्लीटेड ओके As the river deposits soil, rocks and pebbles at its mouth, it results in a triangular landforms known as delta. Okay. So, as I have told you, when the rivers flow, so along with its flow, it will carry soil, rocks and pebbles. Okay. So, mouth of the river means the place where the river meets the sea. Okay. So, while traveling towards the sea, the rivers carry soil, rocks and pebbles. No. So, it will ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ ಅವ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ಸ್ ಪೆಬಲ್ಸ್ ರಾಕ್ಸ್ ತಂದು ಸಮುದ್ರದಾಗ ಮೀಟ್ ಆಗಪ್ಪರಿ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾವ ಓಕೆ ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಡ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿರ್ತದ ರೇತಿ ಜಮಾಗಿ ನೆಮ್ ಜಮಾಗಿ ಏನಿತ್ತು ಹಿಂಗೆ ಒಂದು ಟ್ರೈಂಗುಲರ್ ಶೇಪ್ನಾಗ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ ಇವಾಗ ನೀವು ರೇತಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಹಾಕ್ಲತ್ತೀರಿ ಭಾಳ ಮಣ್ಣು ರೇತಿ ಮನೆ ಮುಂದೆ ನೀವು ಮನೆ ಕಟ್ಟದ ಅಂತ ಹಾಕ್ಲತ್ತೀರಿ ಹಾಕಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ನಾಗ ಹಾಕ್ಲತ್ತಿರ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಶೇಪ್ ಆಯ್ತದ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಎತ್ತರ ಬೆಳಿತದ ಈ ಟೈಪ್ ಓಕೆ ಜಮಾಗಿ 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 ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರೈಂಗುಲರ್ As the river deposits the soil, rocks and pebbles at its mouth, it results in a triangular landform known as delta. Okay, so triangular landform is that. So the name of this triangular landform, which is formed by the deposition of the soil carried by the river, is known as delta.